Rodtang Jitmuangnon, the ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion. In September 2018, Rodtang made his ONE Super Series debut against one of the most accomplished strikers on the planet, Sergio Wielzen.
It's a ONE Super Series Muay Thai clash. Outside knee kick and head kick early on from Sergio Wielzen. He will waste no time. He's going to try and catch Rodtang cold here. And there's Rodtang. A left hook and a straight right hand, followed by a front kick to the midsection.
You can definitely see that Sergio Wielzen knows the atmosphere of the ONE Championship, but he also understands the rule set. So he's coming on a lot faster than normal.
Rodtang, renowned in Thailand for not taking a backward step, always coming forward. A jumping knee from Wielzen. A counter left hand there from the tank, Rodtang.
Wielzen lands a nice little uppercut then, but he got caught flying in with an uppercut. Beautifully done by Rodtang.
Let's see if Rodtang gets on the inside. Starts going to the liver, starts going to the solar plexus, starts going to the spleen of Wielzen. Wielzen goes to the inside leg. Front kick again from Rodtang. This one opening at a cracking pace. A Muay Thai match in the ONE Super Series. Outside leg kick from Wielzen. Suriname has produced so many great kickboxers over the years. The likes of Tyrone Spong, Remy Bunjaski, Melvin Manoff, Ernesto Hoost. And here we have Sergio Wielzen.
That battle between the Netherlands and Thailand continues here at ONE Super Series.
Looking for a dump there, maybe. Rodtang threads the left hand nicely. Rodtang, outside thigh kick, then a front kick to the midsection, uppercut, went higher than my cholesterol. Left hook, right hand there from Rodtang, a high right roundhouse, and just gets upended. 1 minute 25 remains. No feeling out process here in the opening round. They clinch up now. A chance for the knees, a chance for the elbow. And referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
I like how Rodtang utilizes that uppercut. It's a beautiful cutting uppercut, especially because Wielzen's got a little bit of a height advantage on it. Beautifully throws that kick to the side, attacks the body.
Oh, what a dump! What a dump there from Rodtang. My word! The way he pivoted and wrenched Wielzen to the canvas, and there's the tough bumping right hand. Here's the power from Rodtang. There's the left hand.
He's wobbled.
Rodtang comes forward again. There's the left hand. The Thai tank. There's the left again. And Wielzen's knees buckle. No knockdown there. Can Sergio survive the round? Here comes Rodtang again. Amazing scenes here in Jakarta. Rodtang absolutely unloading on Wielzen. He thought he'd knocked him out.
Chavello thought it was over. Rodtang thought it was over. The only one who didn't think it was over was Sergio Wielzen. Look at that, catching the punch on the head. He goes to Wobble Street, falls down, beautiful left hook. Look at this, no legs, legs won't stay under him. Equilibrium is gone. And that's when he called, he heard the good night Irene as he scaled the cage.
You have seen why Rodtang is considered the hottest Muay Thai athlete on the planet. Devastating with these 4 ounce gloves. My word. He put some punishment on Wielzen. But let me tell you, before that, Wielzen got in some blows of his own, and Sergio's not done yet.
What if there's a little bit of an adrenaline dump? If you think you win, that's a surge of adrenaline that's gonna be, you know, rushing through your body. And then to get called back into action, have to get down off the cage, that's gonna change your entire body chemistry, Michael.
Second round, ONE Super Series Muay Thai matchup. The incredible Rodtang, the amazing Sergio Wielzen. Only one can prevail. They touch gloves and we're underway. And Wielzen comes out aggressively. Two-punch combination and a front kick. There's another front kick from the Dutchman. And here comes Rodtang. They want to go toe-to-toe now. Rodtang comes forward, thrusts out the jab. There's a right hand. Cutting side kicks from Rodtang, chasing Wielzen across the cage. Wielzen throws a hook and a straight punch.
Wielzen's still a bit wobbly. He doesn't have his legs completely under him. Beautiful push kick. Caught him coming in.
Through an elbow there, Rodtang. There's the left hook. Wielzen's going to get off the cage. And Rodtang tries the elbow again.
Oh, man, these punches coming from Rodtang, they sound like a bag full of hammers. They are getting thrown with some serious speed.
But Sergio's still here. He's not going to go quietly into the night. He's not going to wave the white flag. And there's another excellent execution. A beautifully timed teep to the midsection from Rodtang.
You can see, and what's caught him off balance is that Sergio is in mid-attack. As he's getting these push kicks down, it's thrown off his balance completely.
Rodtang with more kick than a chorus line. Here in the second round, there's a front kick from Wielzen. Throws one off the left leg. And Rodtang comes forward again. Turning back kick, looking for the liver. Looking to impact that Vegas nerve and close down the body of the Thai.
But how tough is Sergio Wielzen to stand there toe-to-toe with Rodtang?
Wielzen went for the uppercut elbow. Good evasion. He leaned back like Fat Joe. A front kick to the midsection. A front side kick to the midsection from Rodtang. This one is crazy. This one is awesome. It's one Super Series Muay Thai.
Now look at Rodtang stalking down Wielzen.
Stalking. He's trying to roll through him like a tank, always coming forward. There's no backing up on Rodtang.
Look at him, nowhere. Just consistently moving forward. That's what's different about the cage, Michael. There's no corner to back your opponent into. It's a circle. You can continually run around, and that's what's giving Sergio Wielzen a little bit of time in this one.
Amazing scene here in Jakarta for this Muay Thai match. Rodtang with the kicks again off the lead leg. Sergio spinning back fist and just upends himself. 40 seconds remaining, second round of three.
I swear, Rodtang just winked at you, Michael.
They clinch up dead center of the cage. Rodtang breaks off and chops the elbows. He comes forward now. Sergio uppercut elbow. And Rodtang chases him. There's an elbow from the Thai. There's an elbow from the Surinamese. And Rodtang just dumps him to the canvas. 15 seconds on the clock. This has been an absolute rip snorter. Wow. Rodtang again with the power laden left hand. There's the hook. Smack bang. How is Wielzen standing? A spinning back elbow and a counter elbow from Wielzen. A right hand to the kisser. Rodtang with a roundhouse kick. Looks for the clinch. And there's the end of the round. This is something sensational.
Wow. Wielzen is taking a beating, but he is still in there. We are seeing just what all the hype is about with Rodtang. Look at that beautifully timed push kick. Right as Sergio Wielzen is about to even attempt to think about attacking him, he gets pushed back onto his butt. There's a nice little elbow, though, landed by Sergio Wielzen. But look at this control from Rodtang. All the hype, it's real, folks. Rodtang is the real deal.
The hottest Muay Thai athlete on the planet. Started training as an 8-year-old. Had his first match in a temple fair in a small southern Thailand village. Rodtang. And there's Sergio Wielzen. Somehow the South American still here. Made his pro debut at 16. Has beaten some great Thai names. Can he beat Rodtang in front of a sellout audience inside the Jakarta Convention Center?
At this point, he's going to have to knock out Rodtang. He's got to be behind on every single judge's scorecard.
Third and final round, one Super Series Muay Thai match. A high right roundhouse kick there from Sergio Wielzen. Backs him up with the left hand and a southpaw start. There's a wild hooking right from Wielzen. He's opened up like a house on fire. Overhand elbow from Rodtang.
He's marching forward. There's no fear in his eyes. He's continually pushing forward, challenging Rodtang to throw down with him.
Have you ever seen a walk forward style like Rodtang is showing us tonight? He doesn't take a backward step. He doesn't know how to go in reverse.
Man, you can just see the swagger just oozing out of Rodtang. Just the confidence and belief in himself.
Straight right hand and a short right elbow. Smack bang on the kisser. Gives the beard a shave of Sergio Wielzen. Wielzen now on the knees. And Rodtang just ragdolls him and dumps him to the canvas.
Look at him just staring him down, begging him to get up so he can take more of this beating.
Sergio sticks out a stiff jab. That was nicely done. Rodtang goes for the headache maker. There's the uppercut elbow. A wild hook again from Rodtang. He's had more hooks than a Pirates convention. He comes forward again. Overhand right there from Sergio Wielzen. Rides the head kick, covers up with the forearm. Rodtang, action right hand, but only a slip. Says referee Onari. No kick to Wielzen. Picks himself back up. 1 minute 30 remains.
Wilson's continually trying to push forward, but look at this push kick. The timing is beautiful on it. Every single time Wielzen enters that range, boom, the push kick's right there.
Again. Beautifully done from Rodtang. Keeps Wielzen at bay. What has Sergio Wielzen got left in his bag of tricks? This cerebral Muay Thai athlete from the Netherlands. And Rodtang comes forward. Sergio thrust out the left hand. They tango back against the cage. No knees thrown. And referee Onari breaks them.
Go.
Under a minute remaining now. Right hand from Rodtang. They clinch up another dunk in the tie. That is Muay Thai 101. And once again, Wielzen's got to pick himself up off the floor.
Go!
Let's see if Rodtang goes back to the liver. Dips the right hand to the breadbasket. Forces Wielzen back against the cage. And Wielzen comes forward. What guts, what tenacity here from the multi-world champion, Sergio Wielzen. How many shots to the body has he taken from those kicks? There's one to the liver. There's one to the solar plexus. Sergio Wielzen looks spent here. The final 15 seconds. Oh, what has been amazing. He slapped into the side of the head. It's a second knockdown from Rodtang.
Six, seven.
That left hand has been superb.
You said what makes Rodtang so tough, what makes him so hard to deal with, you said it was his body shots. And that is what is breaking Sergio Wielzen. Look at these push kicks continually going after the body over and over again. And Sergio Wielzen just looks dejected.
Rodtang is a Muay Thai monster. The hype proves real at one Super Series.
In favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
With his successful one debut, Rodtang continued up the ranks and faced off against French striker Hakim Hamech at ONE Championship's historic inaugural event in Tokyo, Japan. ONE, a new era.
Behind Rodtang tonight.
They definitely appreciate his Bushido spirit. Immediately attacking that leg, inside and out.
Four ounce gloves, a Muay Thai contest. Rodtang the Tank Jitmuangnon in the red and silver. Hakim Hamech of France in the white and black. Goes to the inside thigh, just Rodtang. Good right hand there from Hakim Hamech. Hamech, a world Muay Thai champion multiple times, should not be underestimated, has speed, has precision. We'll need to rely on those two things and the volume against Rodtang.
Surprised how Hakim Hamech is not moving. He's standing right in front of Rodtang and letting Rodtang just hammer on that lead leg.
Let's see how long it takes for Rodtang to get on the inside and start to land the leather at the moment, kicking range from the tie. Hakim Hamech drifts off to his right, bears the right hand, smack into the kisser, one to the liver, goes off the left from Rodtang, uppercut elbow from Rodtang. Already the heavy artillery being launched in the opening round. Kicks to the midsection from the tank, Rodtang. Ooh, Hakim Hamech stuck with that left hand, and a turning left hook there from the Frenchman. Two of the best Muay Thai countries of the world, well, the best Muay Thai country in the world, Thailand. And you talk about the Western world, well, in history, France is right up there with the Dutch. Maybe a little behind, but not far. But maybe talk about the best Western Muay Thai stylist of all time. There's a big argument to be made for a Frenchman named Danny Bill. Jab two there from Hakim Hamech.
Interesting strategy right now for coming from Rodtang. You can see that first minute was all about the leg kicks. He was just hammering that big leg of Hamech inside and out. Now he's choosing to go to the body. You can see the welds starting to add up on that right side. of Hakim Hamech's body. He's attacking with push kicks as well. I think he's trying to soften Hakim Hamech up, trying to get him to drop that arm and then start to go headhunting.
And two counter there from Hakim Hamech. A lot of great French kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years. The likes, as I said, of Danny Bill, maybe the greatest. Jerome Labana, Dita Diafant, who was an 11-time world champion. Looping left hand there from Hakim Hamech. Looking to follow in the footsteps of the Muay Thai greats. We're talking Samar Payakaru again. Wielzen by Fairtex, Sunshine, Hedgepin Chuefe Group, Diesel Noy. Such a long list from the land of smiles. Referee Elias Delapis right on top of the action here. Final seconds of the opening round. It's been entertaining, but really still a filling out process between these two champs.
You can see that, you know, that in the early, in those first 90 seconds, it was all about Rodtang attacking the legs, and then he went to the body, and that's where he finished that round. But Hakim Hamech was able to land a nice right hand to rock Rodtang. Rodtang ate it down and kept moving forward. Look at that. Beautiful. Touching Rodtang on the chin. Gives him a little smirk and then just starts throwing. Hakim Hamech has got to be a little bit more active. He's connecting when he goes first. He can't allow Rodtang to start hammering the legs and the body. He's got to make sure he keeps that right hand glued to his chin, because you can see Rodtang starts swinging those big shots. He touches you once, he'll sleep you.
Second round of three from inside the sold-out Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo. A little more than 1 hour away from our main card. A big hello to all of our Thai fans cheering on Rodtang Jitmuangnon. They'll be watching live tonight on Thai Rat TV 32. Hakim Hamech just goes to his corner as the cage door closes. Now we should see Rodtang pick up the intensity. In those 4 ounce gloves, there is no room for error. Accidental groin strike there on Hamech. Roundhouse kick, and again from Rodtang. Good jab from Hamech, the jab to it, full extension from the Frenchman. Left hook to a right hook from Rodtang, the tank. Step through knee, Hamech. Nice tuck there from Hakim Hamech.
Hakim Hamech is not giving an inch to Rodtang. He is standing right in front of Rodtang and trading shots with him. We've seen Hakim Hamech, a beautiful counter striker when he wants to. The beautiful sidestep that he performed on Ogasawara to knock him out in one of the final rounds was absolutely brilliant. But this time, he is going toe-to-toe with one of the best strikers in ONE Championship.
Some really good refereeing here from Elias Delapsis, allowing the clinch to go on. Both men staying busy. Uppercut trying to snake in that right arm there. Rodtang worked the clinch around the back of the neck. Can't get it on at the moment though. Needed midsection, folds him in half. Elbow tried to come over the top. There's a step uppercut elbow from Rodtang off the lead arm. Crossing elbows from both men. Another crossing elbow from Hakim Hamech, uppercut from Rodtang. Good crossing elbow to the jaw from Rodtang. Just losing his footing there, Hakim Hamech. Rodtang has gone to the next level here in the second round. Good cover up, close body at Hamech. Hamech returns the favor. 1:05 remains, second round of three, Thailand versus France. Two traditional Muay Thai rivals, two phenomenal Muay Thai countries.
Man, Rodtang is known as just a destroyer. He just comes forward and he runs through everybody. But he's also very technical. Watch him inside the clinch, the way that he parries arms, the way that he blocks biceps. He is controlling so many different aspects, especially at this close range. It's extremely impressive. Watch that clinch game. See how he controls the biceps like that to prevent Hamech from grabbing his head.
Beautiful liver shot there from Rodtang. Hakim turning inside the guard, hugging through the forearms of Rodtang Jitmuangnon, and dumps him to the canvas. Nicely done from Rodtang.
Beautifully done. The way that he kicked, Hamech was coming forward, Rodtang sidestepped, swept out the support leg, and put Hamech face down.
Look how Rodtang wears these punches in the forearms, waits for a pause from Hakim Hamech, and then pounds to the body.
Great.
Excellence in execution from Rodtang. Comes forward again to the tie, escapes the uppercut attempt, fires out a front kick, one more round to go. Once again, folks, scoring on a 10-point must system. The winner of the round gets 10 points, the less dominant boxer gets 9 points. Wherever you're watching around the world, live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the One Super App, live on YouTube, how are you scoring it?
Watch this brilliant work coming from Rodtang inside the clinch. Look at that control on that overhand side. Unable for Hamech to get inside. Soon as Hamech tries to bring the hand up, Rodtang is able to come over the top and land that forearm to the chin of Hamech. He's just showing so many different skill sets every time we see him. We normally see him as this destroyer, this walk forward, just bum rushing people, landing big shots, taking shots, but he's got a technical side to his game that is absolutely beautiful.
Third and final round of this One Super Series Muay Thai clash between Rodtang Jitmuangnon of Thailand and Hakim Hamech. Sold out crowd inside the Rio Goku Kokukigan in Tokyo for a new era, the first time ever that one championship has landed on Japanese soil. Great sportsmanship and respect from both of these warriors.
Stop!
Really dump there from Rodtang.
Again, beautifully sidestepped. Fell Hakim Hamech pushing forward. Sweeps the head out.
Another dump from Rodtang. Now, while those might not necessarily score for Rodtang, what it does is it mentally deflates Hamech. It means he's got to pick himself up off the canvas. Here comes Hamech with a powerful right hand now. Step through a knee from the Frenchman and a crossing elbow. And Rodtang responds. Dumps him again. Continually Hamech having to pick himself up from these dumps of Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
It's deflating, it buries your ego. Look at that control, it just shows the dominance that the Iron Man has inside there. The way that he's able to sidestep, sweep, and then he uses his hand to parry the head down of Hamech to add even more force to the fall.
Clinch, chance for the knees. Late knee thrown there from Rodtang. Comes forward again, that high double forearms guard, throws the uppercut on the hook, uppercut from Hamech, crossing elbow, trying to open the cut on top of the head, glancing right hand from Hamech. Gotta be careful not to drop that head too low, he'll open himself up for a rising knee with Rodtang. Referee Elias Dolapsis breaks him. 1 minute 35 remains, third and final round, a Muay Thai contest here in Tokyo, and another dunk from Rodtang. I've lost count, Mitch.
Michael, you can see that Rodtang has adapted his guard very well to the small gloves. It's very hard for Hamech to land the hooks to the head. You can see him landing them. And the way that Rodtang is wearing those on his forearm is extremely professive. I'd like to see Hamech throw uppercuts. I'd like to see him how he's working the body. That works well, too. Uppercuts to the body shots are going to be how he's going to get this round.
Jab two from Hamech, a little slow though now from the Frenchman. Glancing left from Rodtang, step up elbow from the Thai. Crossing elbow, went all out on that one. Rodtang certainly has some powerful salvos left here with 45 seconds on the clock. Hakim Hamech glances towards his corner. They are imploring him, but it's in French. I don't know what they're saying, but I think I get the general gist. It's come forward. You've got to throw hell for leather now. Uppercut from Hamech listens to his corner.
That's how he's going to find those holes in Rodtang's guard. He's got to land those uppercuts. Go to the body.
Nice elbow there from Rodtang to the orbital of Hakim Hamech. There's the uppercut from the Frenchman.
Rodtang is using those elbows beautifully. Every time he gets into range, every time he's able to control the positioning of the arms, he's able to sneak those elbows right over the top and connect them.
Final seconds of a brilliant contest. And we go down to the judges. Look at the respect. Look at the honor. Look at the martial arts values displayed from these two world champions.
In favor of your winner by split decision, from the red corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Rodtang's next bout took place less than 2 months later and held special significance to earn the number one contender spot for the One Flyweight Muay Thai World Championship.
Go! Traditional respect before they engage. And the Iron Man unleashes with kicks to the inside of the leg, to the outside, and then a teep kick. Takes one in return. It's a battle of the feet at the moment. Exchanging, slapping kicks that will leave bruises for sure. And it's Sok T who's on the rough end of it, and he goes upstairs, Rodtang. Gets pushed back.
Man, I need some slow motion replays on those kicks of Rodtang. Those are coming with some serious speed.
Real hit. 30 seconds. The hands come into play as well at the 40-second mark. Sok T just hoists up his shorts, seeking any protection he can get from these body blows that are coming in at pace. It's lightning quick, Mitch.
It is, and it's coming with some serious power as well. You hear it's a slap, but there's also a thud to the inside of that leg kick as well. Sok T can't allow Rodtang to back his back up against the fence right there. You can see him just slowly inching forward, throwing those leg kicks to just kind of pin Sok T there. Alexi, Sok T circle out.
It's not an exaggeration to say that these kicks are coming in so quickly. Sometimes you're not sure what you've seen. Nice left hand work. Goes body and head, Rodtang. Superb offensive work here, and he bashes himself in the chest and in the face. He's taken more punishment from himself than he has from his opponent in the last 10 seconds. Really up for this. And those legs of Sok T are taking some punishment. He just pushes his opponent back 4 or 5 feet, giving himself a little bit of respite. Doubles up on a jab that lands short. But at the moment, he's off the pace.
Sok T's kind of mesmerized at this point. He's got to do something to earn the respect of Rodtang.
These two hyper-experienced 21-year-olds.
He fainted the jab and then came around to the beautiful left hook.
Sok T just showing us the potential threat there with a big overhead right that might possibly have brushed the nose of Rodtang. But at the moment, all of the really quite exquisite work is coming from the top. And it's relentless. There's no room to breathe. Keep coming in every couple of seconds. Jab, kick.
And his leg kicks are starting to add up.
Sok T gives him a nod after receiving a left hook to the jaw. A nod of respect. Left, right, followed up by kicks. This is exhibition stuff from the Thai athlete.
Leg kicks.
Left hand, and down goes Sok T, and I'm not convinced that he's getting up. He clearly hurt his leg. He's nodding, yes, I can continue, but it doesn't look feasible, Mitch, does it? Saved by the bell.
Wow, those leg kicks are some serious trouble. He was hammering the inside and the outside, and Sok T just fell down.
Look how much trouble he's in, Mitch, struggling to even get on the stool. He's got 1 minute to make amends.
Rodtang just getting aggressive here, punching himself in the face. Like you said, he hit himself more times than Sok T's hit him.
He is like a man possessed. And how about that fantasia? Think she's enjoying herself?
Yeah, the stamp dance here in Bangkok is definitely a sight to behold. But man, those leg kicks. Just punishing. I don't know if Sok T's going to be able to walk back out to the center of the circle.
Well, I'm personally very glad that he got to the bell because I want to see more of this. This is an exhibition, but how much longer can it last? That left leg of Sok T is red raw.
Let's see Sok T's changing the southpaw stance here.
Go! Look at the focus. That time he is like a man possessed.
Sok T's got to check some of these kicks.
Deep kick. Sok T comes back with something, and that's what he has to do. He's got to send a message to his opponent. Meanwhile, right and left, that leg is in big trouble, isn't it?
He's just walking him down, putting his back up against the fence, and then just throwing some nasty combinations.
submissions, and they're all ending with leg kicks.
You've got to admire Sotiri's resilience here and the resistance, but for how much longer? Superb left hook to the body, like Barry McGuigan of old in the 80s. Once again, left hand and right hand. Kicks to the body as well. Again, he goes downstairs with that wonderful left hook to the body.
Just ultra-aggressive. Rodtang marching forward. The tank is rolling through Bangkok.
That is a gorgeous left hook to the body. That leg, how much more can it stand? Again, he goes left hook to the body, right to the head, kicks to the left leg. Sotiri stays on his feet. Directly above us here, circle side, in Bangkok at the Impact Arena. And Rodtang is thrilling these fans.
How tough is Sotiri? He's still in it. He's not backing down, he's not going anywhere.
Left hook to the body, the tree has come down.
For your winner, by way of knockout, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
ขึ้นไปบนเวทีนะผมคิดอย่างเดียวคือแบบต้องชกออกมาให้สนุกเราอย่าไปยึดติดว่าจะแพ้หรือจะชนะ
กูจะให้ความสำเร็จของรถถังความมุ่งมั่นตั้งใจได้เป็นจิตใจก็เข้มแข็งมากกว่ารถถังเป็นคนสู้เป็นคนไม่ยอมกดเป็นคนสู้ชีวิตด้วยฝึกรถสังฝึกขึ้นขอดครับตอนช่วงเช้าวิ่งประมาณ10-12กิโลเมตรวิ่งลุกขึ้นวิ่งประมาณ4:30แล้วก็วิ่งเสร็จแล้วก็มันกระโดดเชือกอีก20นาทีแล้วก็เตะเป้าเตะกระสอบตามขอดที่ได้วางไว้ทางใครก็ได้วางไว้รถถังนี่ตอนนี้เขาจะเก่งเขามีความมุ่งมั่นอยู่แล้วจิตใจเขาคือประเภท
ต้องเสียสละทุกอย่างนะแบบชีวิตแบบส่วนตัวเราคือคิดอย่างเดียวว่าทำไงจะได้เงินมาจุนเจือครอบครัวมาดูแลครอบครัวทำไงทำให้จะทำยังไงให้ครอบครัวมีความสุขก็แบบถึงแม้ความสุขเราอ่ะอาจจะมีน้อยแต่คือเราก็ภูมิใจที่ได้พ่อแม่ลำบากของเราเยอะแล้วก็แบบพอเราโตมาเรามีให้เขาเนี้ยแค่นี้แหละเราก็ภูมิใจที่สุดแหละที่ไม่นึกว่าเราจากเด็กที่ไม่มีอะไรที่ขาดวัยเด็กเลยคือไม่รู้จักทางว่าจะมีแบบนี
้จุดแข็งของรถถังคือสปีดการออกหมัดมากกว่ารู้สึกเขาจะออกหมัดเป็นธรรมชาติกว่านักมวยหลายๆคนที่คนอื่นในค่ายครับธรรมชาติของเขาเลยคือการออกหมัดเขาจะออกได้ธรรมชาติมากแล้วก็แน่นตอนซ้อมต้องความรถถังมีความตั้งใจคือระดับเต็มร้อยเลยครับตอนรถถังตอนซ้อมกับตอนที่ไม่ซ้อมคนละเรื่องเลยนิสัยอุปนิสัยคนละอย่างเลยตอนที่เขาไม่ซ้อมมวยนะเขาเป็นคนที่สนุกตลกสนเสฮากับเพื่อนหยอกล้อแต่พอไปซ้อมเขาจริงจังมากไม่มีเล่นขนาดผมล่อเป้าทำเขาแต่ผมเผลอไม่ได้เลยเผลอต้องหลับคือโดนไปได้ผมไม่เผลอเลยรับรถถังเขามีความมุ่งมั่นและมีความตั้งใจมากในการออกอาวุธแต่ละหมัดแต่ละช็อตของเขาครับ
ผมเองก็ต่อยมวยไทยเป็นเชือกและไม่รู้จักว่าต่อยในกรงมันเป็นไหนก็เลยไม่ค่อยได้สนใจเท่าไหร่ก็ไปติดต่อครั้งแรกก็ไม่ได้เซ็นก็เพราะผมดังอยู่เมืองไทยอยู่รายการต่อเนื่องทุกเดือนใช่แล้วก็แบบยังไม่เซ็นคือแบบพอมาโชคดีก็แบบเหมือนคิดว่าเราต้องก็ได้มาศึกษาดูก่อนถ้ามาขอศึกษาว่าวันแชมเปี้ยนชิพเป็นอย่างนี้ถามคนนู้นนี่ก็บอกดีอะไรนี่เขาจะเทคแคร์ดีมากอะไรเงี้ยก็รอบสองก็ได้ไปเซ็นก็หาช่องทางเพื่อไปช่างเสียงเมืองนอกลองดูบ้างอะไรเงี้ย
รถถังคือมีความยอดเยี่ยมในคือติดอันดับ1ใน10ของเมืองไทยครับและก็ตอนนี้ก็ชาวโลกเขาก็รู้จักรถถังเยอะ
ภูมิใจก็ที่นักมวยคนนึงแบบได้ก้าวมาถึงจุดนี้ได้ก็ภูมิใจในตัวเองครับที่ว่ามาถึงจุดนี้ได้ไง
The biggest bout of Rodtang's career was set. His opponent, Jonathan Haggerty, for the One Flyweight Muay Thai World Championship.
Go! This one brought to you by Hobbs & Shaw. Champion from the UK, left of screen, the challenger from Thailand, right of screen. They exchange round kicks early. Look for the elbows, look for the front kicks. There's one from Haggerty. Look for the sheer brute power of Rodtang. Inside leg kick from the top. More than 140 martial arts world champions on the roster at one championship. You are seeing two of them in the ring at the moment.
Go!
Got to wonder. And Rodtang maintained his composure. High check there. Jab two from Haggerty. That's the precision. That's the excellence of execution from the general.
Good work so far from Haggerty, especially with these kicks, man. And that's what he's doing. He's laying that bait. Now he landed a few push kicks, and now he's starting to feint the push kicks. And that's how he sets up those elbows. He slides in forward and throws those elbows off of that fake push kick.
The push kick of Haggerty, one of the best in the business. Pulls the toes back, extends the ball, the foot, drives it into the midsection of the opponent. Roundhouse kick from Haggerty. There's the push kick, and it's set Rodtang back against the ropes. Again, the second on technique of the 22-year-old world champion from the UK. Front kick again from Haggerty. Scoring points. We do have three judges ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winning boxer 10 points per round. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. At the moment, with the front kicks, it's Haggerty doing the scoring.
Rodtang's having a hard time with the range of Haggerty. That lead push kick is causing a lot of problems for Rodtang. Rodtang's not usually just standing there taking these shots. He's usually the one pushing forward, throwing those shots.
He is landing every one of these front kicks. There's a downward elbow, hoping to crack the collarbone. When we spoke to Haggerty yesterday, we said, what were you most looking forward to about competing against Rodtang? He said, I can't wait to kick him. I can't wait to front kick him. And he's done plenty of that so far, with 45 seconds remaining in the first round set for five.
All those, I like that little change, that little stance change that he does as he throws that right kick.
Look at his flyweight Muay Thai world title on the line. There's a front kick off the lead leg from the general. Nice 3-2 combination. Inside leg from Rodtang, the Iron Man. Both wearing the Project armbands, a little more flamboyant. Those around the left bicep of Haggerty. The more super Project around both the biceps of Rodtang. All part of the tradition, the custom, the superstition of Muay Thai, a martial art dating back some 3,000 years. Front kick again, catches up at his red top. End of the round, we go to the towers. Now once again, the winning boxer of the round, 10 points. The less dominant boxer of the round, 5 points. We are scoring on a 10-point must system.
Look at that beautiful left high push kick, fakes it, and puts the rope save Rodtang from ending up on his butt there. Just that timing is just beautiful coming from Haggerty. He took advantage of the slow start from Rodtang, and that was an exceptional round for Haggerty.
Now, we will say that traditionally the Thais do start very slow. The reason being, however, in Thailand is that betting is done ringside on the contest, not permitted, of course, here in one Super Series. There's no live betting here ringside, but that's why they start slowly in Thailand. So a lot of Thai combatants you do see start very slow in the first, second rounds of a five-rounder, like this is, and really pick up the pace in the third round onwards. So a very slow first round from Rodtang, but over 5 rounds, as we're scheduled here, maybe to be expected.
With over 300 matches, you think it's hard for him to break that habit of traditionally having a slow start?
And usually in one Super Series, he's used so far to having 3 rounds, where there's not much time for a filling out process, not much time to wait and see what your opponent's got to offer. You've got to go hell for leather from the opening bell, but here we have 5 rounds. Front kicks again from Haggerty. Checks the inside leg kick. Rodtang, you feel, is just trying to get his timing off that front kick to work a counter. Maybe it'll be a big overhand right. Maybe it'll be a hooking punch. But that's what he's going to try and time off, the front kick of Haggerty. There you see it again. A catch and counter, scooping to the liver section.
Now he catches it. Now you're starting to see Rodtang. You can see him at the end of that first round, kind of pounding his chest, firing himself up, shaking his head. That's the Rodtang we're used to seeing.
There is a moment in previous contests we've seen where Rodtang goes from Bruce Banner to the Incredible Hulk. Are we going to see it here in the second round? We will see it later on. Nice, hook to the outside, leg kick there from Rodtang. Haggerty switches stance, southpaw now. Front kick off the back leg, now back to orthodox. Very tight in his guard here, Jonathan Haggerty. The 22-year-old world champion from England. Sticks the front kick into the guts again of Rodtang. Good outside leg kick, hard the thigh there from Haggerty.
Rodtang's starting to evade a lot of these kicks now. He's moving his head a lot better, getting out of the way of these. I think he's trying to figure out the reach there. You can see just how long the leg reach, the advantage that Haggerty has. And Rodtang's starting to figure it out a little bit more. Expect Haggerty to start going to the legs and body a little bit more.
Rodtang has the edge in power, but Haggerty, it looks like, has the edge in speed and precision. Down that elbow, looks for a dump from Haggerty. That was, a little late to the play there after referee Onari went to break them, and Haggerty complaining to Onari there.
Yeah, but it wasn't quite really a break. Like, the referee was there, but he didn't really have his hands in there separating them. So, I don't know, maybe it was the angle that I didn't quite see, but it looked like Onari wasn't really trying to break him.
Front kick there from Haggerty. Once again, folks, make sure you follow ONE Championship across all social media platforms on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. A lot of fans watching tonight. Big hello to Mauro Pomali watching in Tuscany, Italy tonight. High kick from Haggerty. Tried to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Outside thigh kick from Rodtang. Now we're seeing Rodtang raise the mercury, raise the temperature, raise the aggressor meter.
This is what Rodtang has to do.
I'll take my feet.
This is what Rodtang has to do. He cannot allow Haggerty to push forward and be this aggressive. He's got to slow Haggerty's aggression down. Cut him off. Start putting heat on him.
Two down, three remaining. 4 ounce gloves in a 5-round world title match. Once again, folks, whoever was the dominant boxer in the second round, give them 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. A beautiful horizontal elbow there from Rodtang, but was it a little late?
Now, I don't know, man. You can see the referee was just kind of standing there. He didn't have his hands in between. You got to go until the referee tells you to stop, and I think Onari just kind of tapped him on the sides there, and he let him continue. That's when that elbow came.
That was all part of ONE Championship Tour de Heroes live from the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. This our co-main event for the Flyweight Muay Thai World title. Sellout crowd tonight, the hottest ticket in town. And Haggerty has had a very good opening 2 rounds. But this is where we expect Rodtang to start to uncork the power salvos. Start to light the fuse, to pull the trigger. And we know that he can, unlike any other. If Rodtang decides to put the foot down and turn it on, strap yourselves in for the ride of a lifetime.
Michael, that's what happened to Sam A. Gyeonghadao. We saw Jonathan Haggerty get ahead in the first couple rounds, and Sam A. Gyeonghadao never got a chance to get back into it because Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
And you see Rodtang now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater. From Rodtang. Haggerty tries to dump him. Rodtang looks like he returned the favor. Both men trade knees to the ribs, and referee Onari breaks it.
That's what Rodtang needs to do. He needs to keep Haggerty on his back foot, not allow Haggerty to go forward and control all those feints.
Rodtang coming forward a lot more already here in this third round of five. That's what he does. That's why they call him the tank. He just comes forward and rolls over you. Roger, that man slipping down. Looks to be leaving the edge as Rodtang. Haggerty tries to counter with a hook off the ropes, drifts back clockwise, thrusts out the jab. You see Rodtang trying to walk him down. He wasn't doing that the first 2 rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand with their toe to toe? Has he going to play that game? Is he going to try to let Rodtang's ego open him up here? Out the lead leg. kicked out the chair. Circles off to his left, but he's going into the power side. Another liver shot, like he's digging for oil. This is a great round from Rodtang. Haggerty evades the leg kick, takes the inside thigh kick, goes high, misses the target. Checks the low kick. Jab from Haggerty. Got to get off the ropes though.
Much better round for Rodtang. This is what we'd expect from the Iron Man to go forward and throw
a
lead.
He's landing a lot clear shots. We're seeing the aggression from Rodtang, and the crowd might be ooh and on, but Haggerty is picking him away, slowly landing jabs, landing kicks.
Jab two combination from the champion on the high kick. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catching duck there from Rodtang. It's scoring stuff from Rodtang. A fantastic round from both men. But did Rodtang edge that one?
Much better round for the Iron Man, but Haggerty had his moments in that round. He was still utilizing that push kick, but everybody seems to be impressed by what the Iron Man is doing right here. Look at this big right hand. Boom! Touches the ear. Goes digging for earwax like a Q-tip inside the side of that ear right there. Beautiful work done by Rodtang in that third round. That's the Iron Man that everybody in the world of Muay Thai was so excited to see tonight. Now he's starting to bring it out. Very close. How do you have that? Maybe 2-1, maybe 1-2. Oof, interesting. Interesting. Rodtang's getting fired up, though, as he stood up on the ring ropes. You rarely see people climbing the ring in the middle of the match.
Haggerty's corner. Nolsey and the crew telling him, go down the center corridor, use your push kick, use your jab, go to the uppercut elbow, come down the center corridor with a sharp technique. Penultimate round of action for the one Super Series Flyweight Muay Thai world title. Jonathan Haggerty versus Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Do you like the counters of Haggerty so far? I like how he's throwing a combination. He steps, then he throws that right kick or that left kick, and he steps back. And that's when Rodtang starts to come forward, and Haggerty's able to hit him or something.
Front kick again from Haggerty, finding range. Outside leg kick from Rodtang.
All that pressure.
The hooking punches and the power up of the four-ounce blocks. You see Haggerty trying to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow. Good front kick, nice long extension off the lead leg. Jab from Haggerty.
A little bit of deflection right there from Rodtang as that jab came in lightning fast.
Nice tip to the lead thigh from Haggerty. Then skips up inside thigh kick, threads the jab again, takes an outside leg kick. Body shots. Oh, the shots hurt him. The liver shots hurt the champion.
Haggerty's got to move.
And Rodtang knows it. He's going to go to that liver. He's going to try and blast the right side of the body of the champion. And Haggerty needs to find a way to cut him. Needs to find a way to open him up with the elbows now. And then drops it. The big kibosh. And Haggerty goes down. Referee now puts the count on. And he's up on his feet. But he's been rattled. It was a beautiful hooking punch from Rodtang. And here comes the Iron Man. Here comes the tank. Rodtang marching him down, eats a jab. Haggerty circles away from the power side. There's a front kick. Haggerty's got to give himself a chance to recover. And Rodtang says, stop dancing, come and engage with me. He's trying to get inside Haggerty's mind. He wants Haggerty to play his game. Wants him to suck it into a brawl. But Haggerty not falling for it. He's not going to take the bait yet. Oh, nice front kick there. A taste of the feet once again for Rodtang. Downward elbow! Hoping for the collarbone. Jack. But he's doing a Beyonce. He's going to the left, to the left. He's going to go to the right, to the right. Go. Stay away from the power side of Rodtang.
He's doing a good job of slowing down. Go. He says, this is for a belt. Come on, let's go toe to toe.
And how about this?
Get into it.
Haggerty calling Rodtang forward, saying, no, you come on. You bring it. I'm not not coming to you. You've got to come to me.
Yeah, that's just mind games, though. He's still moving, though. He's on his bicycle. Looks at him, points to the ground, says, let's go.
Haggerty playing the mind games. Saying, I made you lose your ground. Come on back into the phone booth.
Oh, it's going to come down to the fifth and final. That knockdown, Rodtang could have a slight edge in the scoring. If the scorecards, depends on how the judges saw that third round. It's very close right now. Look at him coming forward. Boom, with just a wild hooking combination, sends the champion crumbling to the mat as Rodtang starts to turn on the heat. Look at that right hand comes through the guard. And then Haggerty got on his bicycle and started circling, staying away from him. Keeping the taunting going, keeping it interesting, but you can tell Haggerty was hurt. This is a different Haggerty that we're seeing right now. Haggerty needs to reach down deep, develop that, bring out that champion's mindset, put it all on the line, because I think it comes down to the fifth and final round.
Such amazing respect I have for these two world champions. These two phenomenal athletes. And look at this sellout crowd in Manila at the Mall of Asia Arena, and what a show they've seen. This is one for the ages. Haggerty engaging in the mind games with Rodtang. And there's a moment of respect. The fifth and final round for the Flyweight Muay Thai world title. They touch gloves. It could be drawn at the moment. Once again, winning boxer gets 10 points. Losing boxer in the round, in your opinion, gets 9. Usually, if there's a knockdown, it's a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I think that knockdown changed it, though. I think it changed it. Beautiful evasion there from Rodtang.
Rodtang showboats. A little too slick. Roundhouse kick from the top. Haggerty, cheek down the center. Needs the elbows. 2 now. And not allow Rodtang to go to his liver and then sling the hand to the jaw. Those hooking punches of Rodtang are phenomenal. And the general goes to the legs. One way to slow down the punching of an opponent is to kick their legs. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and comes up the body.
Haggerty's scoring with the leg kicks there, but you can see Rodtang catching the kick, sweeping out the leg, putting it down. Now dumps do count as a clean technique.
Finds a push kick. Haggerty. Rodtang may be waiting for the final 60 seconds or so here.
He can't wait, though. Haggerty's doing a lot of scoring here with his legs, pushing on the teeth.
Yeah, this
look at
is Haggerty's round so far. No
that's
doubt
scoring,
about it.
That's scoring, Michael. That's scoring. All these things are scoring.
Rodtang throws two punches, doesn't connect. Tucks the round kick on the forearm. Haggerty catches that one. There's one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Haggerty, nice roundhouse kick. Rodtang on the front foot, eats a jab. Body shots, then the hooks to the head. Chance for the knees and elbows on the inside here.
Strong into that clinch, wraps his hand around the head. Throws a little bit of a knee, but chooses to let it go.
1 minute 5 remaining, fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World. Jab 2 from Jonathan Haggerty. Front kick from Haggerty, it has been superb all night. It is the prime weapon of the champion. Nice stiff right hand. Rodtang apologizing.
We'll
say no, maybe Haggerty accidentally slipped a finger in the eye. It happens with these open gloves. Front kick, testing the waters here, Haggerty. Can he thread an overhand elbow to the top of the head perhaps? Or maybe skip in for a downward elbow to the collarbone?
30 seconds, Michael. This is it right here. Last 30.
Does one of these two men pounce on the other now? Jab 2, a high kick from Jonathan Haggerty.
Nice 2 landing there by Haggerty as he cut through the guard.
This is going to be razor close, folks. This is going to be a razor close decision. Haggerty switches now back to orthodox.
If Haggerty can take this round, it might be even, and they have to go to criteria for that.
No draws in one super series. No draws. We are going down to the judges.
All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and new one Flyweight Muay Thai World champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.